Convicted of murdering a robber more than 2 years ago, tonight pharmacist Jerome Ersland faces life in prison.
Our cameras were there when he walked out of the courtroom. When he heard his sentence, our reporters say he showed no emotion. Eyewitness News 5's Jessica Holloway's live with the big story. Jessica, Ersland was happy when he arrived in court today.
Well, Paul, when he showed up here at the courthouse, he was happy, but he left here disappointed. After years of waiting, Jerome Ersland is finally learning his fate. Life in prison. He smiled on his way into court. His supporters couldn't believe his sentence.
I think all of us are a little bit surprised. I mean, I think it's like the Casey Anthony trial. It was something that people did not necessarily expect.
And I feel for his family, and I wish them the best.
I think it was a bad decision, and I'm hoping and praying that, you know, the appeals and what I'm doing will work.
Judge Ray Elliott said he's carrying out the sentence the jury handed down. District Attorney David Prater did not speak to reporters. In court, he said Jerome Ersland told 7 different stories about what happened. Ersland's son says this has not been easy on the family.
And initially, I figured he would probably have the most luck with a pardon parole board.
Ersland will return to jail, this time for life, but on his way out, he said this to us.
Yeah, it's injustice of a monumental proportion.
So what do you plan to do from here?
Appeal.
And the pharmacist will not be eligible for parole until he's 97 years old. Reporting live from the courthouse, Jessica Holloway, Eyewitness News 5.
And Jerome Ersland will spend the next month and a half in the Oklahoma County Jail.
After that, officers will move him to prison, but that is just the beginning. His family and his attorney says they will appeal the conviction and the sentence.
Like pharmacists that have been victims of robberies, we had a police officer that a few months after this case shot and killed someone during a nonviolent crime.
Irvin Bach says the judge didn't let his side present some evidence and call some witnesses to the stand. He says that is the goal with the appeal, and he says he feels he has a case that should be overturned.